Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to explain about dependency tests in TestNG, and then we'll see always run property. So let's start with this. So what is dependency test in TestNG? So sometimes what happens is when I create multiple test methods in the test case, there will be some dependency. So for example, some test cases depends on some other test and that output is depends on some other test. So how we can manage these dependency tests? So let's see practically. I'm just opening my IntelliJ and here I'll create a new test, go to Java class and I will name it as dependency example. Okay. Now inside this class, I'll create a few test methods. So for example, the first method I'll say void start car, and this is one method. And inside this, I will just write a simple message called system.out.println car started, and I'll make this as @ test annotation. Similarly, I will also create a few test methods. So the next one is drive car, public void, or we can no need to have public, so we can just have void drive car, and I can make this also a test annotation. And car driving, this is output message. And similarly, I will also create one more method, that is stop car. And inside this, I will write again a simple message, car stopped. And also I will specify this with @ test annotation. And finally, I'll create one more method, park car, and it will print car parked. And here I'll also specify the @ test annotation. All right, so now I have created four test methods: start car, drive car, stop car, and park car. And you can also give the priority if you want to give. But here I am specifying the dependency. So for example, I want to drive the car. So if I want to execute this method, first car should be started. So this method is dependency method. So before executing this method, I need to check whether start car method is passed or not. If it is successfully executed, passed, and then drive car should be continued. Similarly, if I want to execute stop car, drive car should execute and pass. It is a dependency test for stop car. Then if I want to park a car, I need to stop car. And also let's say sometimes the test method is depends on multiple methods. Let us assume park car is depending on stop car and drive car. So let us say how we can specify this dependency. So the first method don't have any dependency. So from the second method is dependency is there. So drive car is depending on start car. So I can add one parameter here is called depends. This is parameter called depends on methods. So depends on methods is equal to, in the curly braces, we have to specify the name of the method. I'll say start car in the double quotations. Now start car is executed and passed, then only driver car will execute, drive car will execute. And similarly, I will also specify the dependency for stop car, and this is depends on drive car. So I'll pass drive car here. And park car is depends on two more test methods. For example, if I want to specify two methods, so park car is depending on two test methods. Let us say one is stop car and other one is drive car. So I can add multiple methods like this. We can just comma, add comma, and put the double quotations. So we can also specify the multiple dependence methods. So now I have added all the dependencies, right? So driver car is depending on start car, stop car is depends on drive car, and park car is depends on both the methods, drive car and stop car. So when I execute this code, it will first verify the start car is passed or not. If it is passed, then only drive car will execute. If the drive car is passed, then only stop car will execute. If both these methods are passed, and then park car will execute. So this is a functionality. Now let us execute this code for now. So run our dependency example. Now we can see here, now my test is started. Right, so now we can see car started is executed, car driving is executed, stopped is executed, and car parked is executed. So everything is fine. Now what I want to do is I want to just fail my first test method. As observe this, I'm writing some asset method, asset dot fail. So this command will intentionally make failure out test case. So here the command is asset we have to import from TestNG. So asset from TestNG. Okay, so asset dot fail. So this command will make our test method fail. So now start car is failed. Now what happens? Driver car is depending on start car. So driver car will not execute. It will just ignore. And obviously stop car is depending on the drive car. So it will also ignore. So park car is also depends on stop car. So this will also ignore. So overall, finally, all the test methods will be ignored if the first method is failure because all are dependent methods. So save and execute one more time. Run dependency example. So I have just started through coverage. Okay. Let me run one more time. Run start test. Just hold on. Start one more time. So right click. I have started as coverage. So that's the reason it is giving something else. So let me execute it. Save. And I should get a run option. So if we don't get here, we have to run from here. Run dependency example. Now it is started. Right, so now we can see start car is failure and rest of the methods are just ignored. It's not executed because they are dependency methods. So now what I can do here is, even though the dependency method is failure, right? Fail. So still I want to execute the method. Even though the dependency method is failed, I want to still execute the method forcefully, right? So in that case, we need to add this particular property. So always run property we have to add. So what this property will make us, this property will always execute the method even though the dependency method is failed. So for example, let me take the last method. Park car is depending on two different methods, drive car and stop car. So anyway, drive car, stop car will be ignored. So not executed. So park car is also failed here. Even park car is also ignored. So but still I want to execute this park car even though the dependent methods are failure. Then here I can add one more property called always run is equal to true. So when I add this particular property true, then this method will always execute even though the dependency method is failure. Let's execute again, save it and run dependency example. Now you can see the output now. So the last method still executed. Now you can see the first method is passed. And these drive car and stop car is ignored and still park car, even though this is depending on two different methods, still it is executed and it is also passed. Right. So this is how we need to add dependency methods by adding depends on methods property along with the test annotation. So we have learned dependency test in TestNG, how to use always run property. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.